A day in the life of a record dealer starts here. Hey Nelson, we've got to get you out of the door to the office so you don't bite the heads off other dogs. Isn't that right, buddy?
Hey.
A day in the life of a record dealer. My collection, very small compared to most. Right, we'll see you at the office. So, we're on our way now. That is my works van. Well, in fact, my only transport, because it doubles up. It's a works van to allow me to pick up collections and do my markets. I don't do record fairs anymore, because it's the same crap, the same dealers, the same people, the same customers all the time looking for the same stuff. So I stopped doing them. Go on, mate, in you get. Good boy. And it doubles up so that myself, the girlfriend, and Nelson can go away at weekends. Right. There's a dog in there. Hello, mate. There he goes. Excited to go to work. I'll see you at the office. So this keeps you busy, doesn't it, Nelson, for a few minutes. There you go, mate. Enjoy that. So what we got here is our office. It's not pretty. I've ripped the carpets out that were in here for about 30 years of the previous tenant. Lovely. But I'd moved everything in first. So with all the weight of records, and we're in a grade 2 listed building, it does slope inwards into where the table is. Thankfully, not created by me, it was the previous tenant. But yes, the floor slopes at about 2 degrees. So this is Desirable Vinyl's hub. More importantly, this is our snack bar. I give myself a boost of Red X to get myself pepped up in the mornings, you know. Don't put it into petrol engines, just put it into me. Peanut butter essential, and snacks, and dog snacks, and a kettle. Every record dealer needs a kettle. So, this is the start of my day. So, I don't have any appointments on this particular day, but normally I have an appointment system. People can come in, spend as little or as long as they want, and just look through stuff. That's DVDs, that's singles, and then all albums, obviously, here. This is stuff that's come in, so this is my prep area. That's an all-important TV so that I can play music all day. So we're around midday. I have about 10 records left to clean. That's the next batch that's been done, ready to... They've been databased, half have, half haven't. They're all ready to go. So I've cleaned these. A couple of them had a few marks on, so I'm just doing a play test. This happens to be ELO's Out of the Blue, track one of the first record, Turn to Stone. So I then put these on eBay. Most of my records are selling through eBay. I don't sell on Discogs anymore. Used to. I just don't like Discogs policies. They charge you, for example, a percentage on shipping. Well, that's not their responsibility. That's down to me. The all-important cup of tea that has to be running all day. I'm a sleep dog. He's pretending to be asleep, but really wants to just go for a walk. So I go basically put stuff on the list on eBay. Yes, I do use a template that I created myself. So I click on Motorhead, for example, right? A Lost Tapes Live. It's a new mint one that I've got for sale at the moment. It just happens that I put it on there. You'll find me as Desirable Dash Vinyl. I've currently got 950 feedback. 100% positive, because I do pride myself in selling it correctly. Although I've actually just put in their condition used, that's confusing, so I'm going to have to update that. So actually, that's a good reason to go in. So I do carry out price comparisons, for example. If I've had something on sale for, say, a month, and I've not had any viewers, watchers, offers, I basically allow offers on everything. Be sensible. This is a £40 record. Don't offer me 25, 30 quid. I won't say yes. I probably won't respond to you. So why? Yeah, it says it's mint. This is the problem. There's so many options now for where to put stuff. Yeah. Not quite sure. I'll have to find that later when we're not doing this. But I basically list, the way I list, there are photos of the actual product. There's my camera. I use a proper SLR for it. I do that after I've cleaned, so I can check everything, look at it in detail. These haven't been cleaned yet. That hasn't been cleaned, so I don't know if that's going to come off. If it doesn't, I will list it as that, and you will see that in the photo. What you won't see in photos, there's a scratch there. See what I mean? It's really hard. There we go. There's a scratch there. Very rarely will you actually be able to see that on a photo. And I will list it. I will say, and if there's multiple scratches, I'm not going to tell you exactly where they all are. I'll just say there are multiple hairline scratches or light scratches or deep scratches. If there's something that makes the record click, I will tell you. You know, I do miss them sometimes. You know, I mean, that's a lot of listening just for that. And this is my living. This is what I do. So it's a question of optimizing my time, making sure that stuff's online, that I can make a living off it, but be honest and not cut corners. I don't like cutting corners with stuff. Hey Nelson, later on I will be going through some of my comedy records and doing exactly the same. They need checking and cleaning. I use Discogs generally as my database, but as I say, I let it sell through it, and they're all comedy albums as well. And then I've got to do a stock take, and that's all folk, Stones, Beatles, Beach Boys, etc., etc. All right, so that's typical day's work, really. On top of that, obviously, I've got to ship this stuff. I've had no orders today, sadly. It's very quiet, very, very, very quiet. So I'm also doing tapes. I sell used tapes, which I check and rewind and make sure they spool properly and run properly, and I blank them all pre-shipping using a high quality tape deck, and these are ones ready to go. And I also sell brand new cassettes as well, boxed cassettes. And then so that is, see, these kind of things are great find. Yesterday, for example, I sold Black Sabbath's first album, third pressing, 50 quid in good plus condition, to a regular customer, and he had Metallica's S&M 2 on 4-disc vinyl, so I did a bit of a swap with him, to be honest. All right, cheers everybody. I don't think there's anything else to let you know about at the moment.